Hey everybody, my name is Sarah, and this is a level 1-2 fluid class. A couple of props that you might want to have handy are blocks. I usually use 2 blocks. If you don't have blocks, you could use books or anything else that you could put some weight on. A blanket or a towel. And if it's comfortable for you to sit on a cushion or a pillow, you can grab that as well. You can also use your blocks and sit on the block. So we'll just begin here in a comfortable, quiet, seated position. You can close your eyes. Just take a moment to allow yourself to settle in. To allow your body to release and relax into your seated posture. Maybe make note of anything in your body that you would like to pay attention to during your practice today. So if you notice any areas of tension, you notice places that are feeling sore or achy, just make note of that. And as you move through your practice, make sure that you are really honoring your body and not taking any risks or pushing yourself in a way that doesn't feel good. We really want our yoga practice to be adapted to our bodies rather than trying to force our bodies into a particular pose or a particular flow. Just take another few breaths here. And then keeping your eyes closed, draw your shoulders up towards your ears and then let them fall down your back. And just take a few shoulder circles, just kind of some nice, useful ways of introducing some movement into your shoulders and into your upper chest. And squeeze your shoulder blades together behind you. Let your arms drop down. You can open your eyes at this point if your eyes are still closed. Let's inhale, reach both arms up overhead. Interlace your fingers, press your palms towards the ceiling. Try to find some length here through the sides of your body. And then on your exhale, round your back, pressing your arms forward, out in front of you. This is hard on your wrists, so you can turn your hands around so your knuckles are facing forward instead of your palms. And see if you can round through your upper back so that you're separating. On your next inhale, rise back up, lift your arms, maybe lift your gaze up. And then exhale again, round your back. Arms pressing forward, palms out or in, whatever is more comfortable. Inhale, lift back up. Exhale, round your back, bring your arms out in front of you. This time, take little circles. You know, circle your palms around a couple of times, and then take those circles in the other direction. And on your next inhale, lift your arms up overhead. This time on your exhale, release your right arm to the ground. Take a side bend towards your right, reaching out from your left fingertips. Inhale, both arms back up overhead. Exhale, take your left arm down. Take your side bend towards the left side, reaching out from your right fingertips. Inhale, both arms back up. This time we'll take a twist towards the right side. So bring your right hand behind you. Left hand can rest on your leg or even on your shin. Take an inhale to bring some length into your spine. And then on your exhale, twist more deeply. Maybe moving your gaze back, maybe turning your chest to the side. Inhale, both arms back up overhead. Exhale, twist to the left side. Same thing, inhale, lengthen to your spine. Exhale, move into the twist. Inhale, both arms back up overhead. Exhale, reach your arms behind your back. So interlace your fingers, take an in-breath, you're lifting your chest, maybe lifting your gaze, squeeze your shoulder blades together, find some opening in the front of your chest. And then your exhale, release the whole thing, hands back to your arms. So if you're sitting on a blanket or bolster, you can move that off to the side of your mat. We're gonna come into a tabletop position. So as we come into tabletop, I always like to have some cushioning. And then my knees, you can grab your blanket here. Place your blanket under your knees. And then set yourself up so that your hands are a little bit in front of your shoulders. So you're not putting too much pressure through the heels of your palms. Spread your fingers, point your index finger forward. Really root down into your index finger knuckle. And we'll take some cat cows here. So on your in-breath, drop your belly, lift your gaze. On your out-breath, round your back, tuck your chin into your chest. Inhale, belly drops, gaze lifts. Exhale, round your back. Continue to flow through cat-cows, following the pace of your breath. And add in any movement. So maybe you circle your hips around. And you just move your hips from side to side. You can sit back towards your heels, reaching your arms forward. Or roll forward towards a cobra pose, maybe lowering your hips, lifting your chest a little bit. And on your next inhale, find a neutral spine. Tuck your toes under. Check in on your hands again. Make sure your fingers are spread. Index fingers pointing forward. We're going to lift our hips into downward facing dog. So as you come into our downward facing dog, feel free to keep your knees bent, especially if you have tight hamstrings. So press the hips towards the ceiling. Pedal your feet. Lifting one heel as you drop the opposite heel. Maybe sway your hips from side to side here. And just take a few breaths, kind of settling in. Notice what your body is like in your downward facing dog. Notice if there is anything that you need to pay attention to. You're feeling a lot of pressure in your wrists. Try walking your hands forward and out a little bit and turning your hands up. On your next in-breath, draw your shoulders forward. Come into a plank position. And in our plank position, we want to try to keep our body as level as possible from our heels to our shoulders. So that we're not lifting the butt or sinking down. We're really keeping steady. Try to keep your breath even in your plank pose. On your next exhale, we're going to lift the hips and turn to downward facing dog. And now step your right foot forward. And you can come up onto your fingertips here. This is a good place to grab your blocks. If you're using blocks, if you've got tight hamstrings, and you place your hands on blocks. We're in our crescent, we're in our low lunge here, we're going to come into a crescent now. So on your inhale, lift your arms, lift your torso. Keep your gaze forward, see if you can straighten your elbows in your crescent lunge. Right? Even if that means maybe your arms are a little bit wider than they normally would be. And then bring your hands to your hips. Draw your elbows back, lift through your chest a little bit. And bend your back knee just a tiny bit. See if you can bring your left hip forward. And then straighten your back leg back behind you. Reach your arms back up overhead. On your next exhale, take your hands to the ground or to blocks. and straighten your front leg. So we're going to come into kind of a modified pyramid. You notice change the height of your blocks if you're using blocks. And in your modified pyramid pose, the front leg is mostly straight. Again, if your hamstrings are tight, you can have a little bit of a bend to that knee. We're going to kind of move here in our pyramid pose by shifting the hips. And lean over the leg, shift the hips forward, shift the hips back. Just notice in your body how this movement changes the stretch, the intensity. And then the next time you shift your hips forward, we'll drop that back knee again, bend into the front leg. Untuck your toes. So you can either stay here with your hands supported on blocks, or reach your hands up onto your thigh, your right thigh. Or reach your arms up overhead. If you're taking this option, make sure that your lower back feels supported as you reach your arms up. And then you're lifting your rib cage. You're not just sinking into the lower back. And your next exhale, hands down to the floor or blocks. We'll straighten the front leg. And you might move your foot forward a couple of inches to take a runner's lunge. So here again, the front leg is mostly straight, right? You have a little bit of a bend to your knee. And you want to keep your chest lifted and your back engaged, even if you're pretty flexible. So we'll take an inhale, and then on your exhale, just lean forward, just kind of dip over your front leg. Inhale, rise back up, straighten your elbows. Exhale, dip over the front leg, just fold it lightly. Inhale, lift. Exhale, fold it. We'll hold it this time for a couple of breaths. And now we'll bend back into the front leg. Okay, tuck your back toes under. We're back in that low lunge position. Plant your hands and set your right foot to the back of your mat, turning to your downward facing dog. And then move around to your downward dog, pedal your feet. And move your hips a little bit. On your next inhale, find your plank pose. This time, lower your knees to the ground, and then slowly lower your torso onto the floor. Okay, keep your hands positioned by the sides of your rib cage. As you inhale, lift your chest lightly. Think about your elbows moving back, your shoulder blades moving towards the middle. Exhale, release down. Inhale again, lift your chest, your elbows back, shoulder blades in. Exhale, release. Inhale, this time lift a little bit higher. So maybe start to straighten your elbows. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lift, approaching your king cobra pose. Exhale, fold over. Inhale, lift, if you can, go ahead, straighten your elbows, and then move through your table position, and lift your hips back into your downward facing dog. Take an in-breath. On your exhale, send your left foot forward. And again, you can grab the blocks here. So you can have your hands on your blocks. We're starting here in our low lunge position. And then when you're ready, inhale, lift your torso, lift your arms up overhead, coming into your high lunge. Just take a moment to notice on your left side, how the left side might be different, like feel a little bit different from the right side. Take some deep breaths. And now reach your hands to your hips. Pull your elbows back. Then you're going to open any in the front of your chest. And then bend a little bit into the back leg. Just a little bit, so you can kind of swing your right hip forward. And then straighten the back leg. Reach your arms up overhead again. And take your hands down towards your blocks. And then straighten your front legs. You're coming towards that modified pyramid pose. Again, you can bring the blocks in a little bit. You can change the height. And just like we did on the other side, we're going to shift a little bit. Move the hips forward, and then move your hips back. Start to find a little bit of movement, and notice how that affects how you're experiencing the stretch in your hamstrings, or the stretch in your hips or your back. We're going to inhale, lift here, lift the chest a little bit. Exhale, fold in. Bend through your front knee. And then drop your back knee onto the ground. Untuck your back toes. This is our low lunge position, our Anjaneya Asana. So you can stay here, and if this is comfortable for you, your hands on your blocks. You can also maybe try lifting your hands up onto your left thigh. So we're looking here for a stretch in the front of the back thigh, so the front of your left thigh and hip thrusters there. This is comfortable. Go ahead and reach both arms up overhead, coming fully into the pose. And make sure again you feel supported in your lower back. Make sure you're pressing the top of your feet, your right foot into the ground. And your next exhale, release your hands down to the floor or to blocks. Shift your hips back, then straighten through your front leg. Keep your hands up on blocks for now if you're using them. Lift your chest a little bit. Notice how this side might be different from the first side. Maybe your hamstrings feel a little more open or a little less open. Take an inhale, extend through your spine. On your exhale, just dip in over your front leg. Inhale, rise up. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lift your chest. Exhale, fold in. Hold this for a couple of breaths. And now begin to bend into your front leg. Turn towards that low lunge position. Tuck your back toes under. Lift your back knee. Here's where you can move your blocks aside. Plant your hands and then step back again into your downward facing dog. Again, notice how your body is changing and shifting as you introduce more movements, as you start to stretch and strengthen different areas. On your next inhale, plank pose. And we'll pause here briefly in plank pose. Press into your hands. And then lower your knees to the ground and lower all the way onto your belly. Place your hands in front of you. So I'm gonna offer a few options here for back bends. The first one is just with your hands in front of you, place your forehead on your hands. That's probably the most gentle version. You can also come into Sphinx pose. You're propping yourself up on your elbows, and your forearms are on the ground in front of you, roughly parallel to one another. If you're opting for your Sphinx pose, press your hands to the ground, lift your chest. But keep your gaze down towards the front of your mat rather than lifting your head. Just take a couple of breaths in whatever back bend you're choosing. On your next exhale, release down. Place your hands next to your ribs. Inhale, straighten your elbows for cobra pose. And then on your exhale, downward facing dog. Begin to walk forward, coming towards the front edge of your mat. Separate your feet. Have a little bit of a bend to your knees. Just hang over your legs for a moment. Maybe shake your head out. Maybe hold elbows and sway from side to side. And release your hands down. Inhale, hands to shins or thighs, lift your chest. And come to your flat back position. Exhale, fold over your legs. Inhale, hands to shins or thighs. Exhale, fold. Inhale, reach your arms out and up, rise to stand. Exhale, hands by your side. So mountain pose or Tadasana is when you're standing with your feet, they don't have to be touching, but they're sort of close together. You don't have a wide stance. Arms resting by your sides, shoulders back. Chin in the same plane as your forehead. And you want your breath to be even and comfortable and controlled in Tadasana. This is the starting point for our sun salutations. So I'll offer some modifications as we move through our sun salutations. You can take whatever modifications you want. You can also do your own modifications or skip certain elements that you're not comfortable. From the front of your mat, we'll stand, we'll start in Tadasana. Inhale, both arms up overhead. Exhale, fold. Inhale to a flat back. Exhale, plant your hands, step to downward facing dog. Inhale to plank pose. Lower your knees to the ground. We're going to bend the elbows and just dip forward a little bit, half chaturanga. Inhale, lift your chest, straighten your elbows. Exhale, downward facing dog. Just breathe here in your downward facing dog. Lift your heels, bend your knees, look forward. We're going to walk to the front of our mats. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold. Inhale, sweep your arms out and up. Exhale, Tadasana. Inhale, both arms up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, this time step to your plank pose. You can lower your knees again for chaturanga or shift forward, bend your elbows, hover. Inhale to upward facing dog or cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Lift your heels, bend your knees, look forward, walk to the front of your mat. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, fold. Inhale, sweep your arms out and up. Exhale, Tadasana. So we're going to stand on our mats and move through some standing poses. I need to grab my water bottle really quick. Okay, so from the front of your mat, step your left foot behind you. We're coming into our Warrior Two pose. So right foot is in front, and if you were to draw a line from your right heel back, it's going to intersect somewhere along your left arch. Bend into your front knee. Now you don't want your front knee to shoot past your ankle. You can have it a little bit behind your ankle if you're just starting out, or you can have it your knee more on top of your ankle. Arms extend out front to back, and then turn your gaze forward over your right fingertips. And take a few breaths in your Warrior Two pose. Notice how this feels in your body. And notice the strength you have in your legs to support you in Warrior Two. And now bring your right forearm to your knee and reach your left arm forward for extended side angle pose. You can turn your gaze up towards the ceiling. If that's not comfortable on your neck, you can look down at the floor. And then bring your left hand back around to your left hip. We're going to move here into a balance pose. I like to use a block for this balance pose. It's called half moon pose. You can also, if you've got space in your room, you can back yourself up to the wall so that you're doing this against the wall. And we're going to step the back foot forward, and we're going to take the block. Now the block is going to be positioned forward and slightly to the outside of my front foot. Left leg lifts, flex through the left foot. You can keep your left hand on your hip for balance, or start to turn your chest open and reach your left arm towards the ceiling. Another way to challenge your balance here is to shift your gaze up towards the ceiling. Try bending your left knee, reaching your left hand back for your foot, and maybe pressing your foot up into your hand. You've got your foot, release that. And then drop yourself back to your Warrior Two pose. Straighten your front leg, hands to your hips again. We're gonna turn the hips slightly forward, and then fold over for a triangle pose. Okay, you're gonna fold over your front leg. I use a block here as well, under my hands. So right hand on the block, turn your chest towards the ceiling, and reach your left arm up overhead. And again, you can turn your head up so that you're looking past your left fingertips, or you can take your gaze towards the floor if that's better on your neck. And see if you can notice your breathing. Take some long, slow inhales and exhales. A couple more breaths in your triangle pose. Really see if you can press down into your big toe joint. Not the big toe itself, but the big toe joint. And your next inhale, rise to stand. Turn your right toe so that you're facing the side of your mat, hands to your hips. On your inhale, lift your chest. On your exhale, fold forward, bringing your hands to the ground. You can place a block. If your hamstrings are tight, you can place a block underneath your hands. You can also just have your hands on the ground and fold again. Inhale, lift your chest here. Exhale, bring your hands to your waist. Inhale, rise to stand. And now we're going to do the other side with that same standing sequence. So turn down, turn so that your left foot is facing the end of your mat. And if you were to draw a line from your left heel back, it's intersecting somewhere along your right foot. And then bend into your left knee for your warrior two pose. Arms extend out. Turn your head in the direction of your left hand. Just take a few breaths. Notice how your left side might be different from your right side. And now take your left forearm down onto your thigh. Reach your left or right hand towards the front of your mat. Really see if you can lengthen along the right side of your body. So press your outer edge of your right foot into the ground. Reach through your right fingertips. Try to keep your breath steady and even. Think about that opening along the side of your body. Inhale, return towards your warrior two. We're coming down into our half moon pose. So right hand to your hip. You're using your block, grab your block, and we'll step forward. And again, this time the position of the block will go forward and slightly to the outside of the left foot. Lift your right foot. Your right leg, flex through your right ankle. You can keep your hand on your waist. I'm less steady on my left side, so I'm making your hand on your waist here. You can even shift your gaze. If you're comfortable, you can turn your gaze up towards the ceiling. And then if you would like, bend your right knee. So you can reach back with your right hand. It's okay if you fall out of this pose. You can just come back in. And try it again. Press your right foot up into your hand. Take a little bit of a back bend here. Now, if you're holding your foot, release your foot back. You're going to put the whole thing back into warrior two. Okay, so once you get back onto the ground, go ahead and adjust your stance as needed. And then straighten your front leg. So we'll take a slightly shorter stance for triangle pose. Turn your hips, we're just angling the hips instead of forward. We're going to angle them about 15 degrees. Or I'm sorry, instead of up to the side, we're going to angle them about 15 degrees forward. And then fold over. Use your block here if you like. Turn your chest open. And reach your right arm towards the ceiling for triangle pose. And as you're in triangle pose, try to even out your breath. Pay attention to the length and intensity of your inhales and your exhales. Just a couple more breaths and try to close. And then bend into your front leg. Actually, no, keep your front leg straight. Rise back up to stand. We'll turn the feet again so that both feet are facing the sides of your mat. Take an in breath, lift your chest. On your exhale, fold forward again. You can bring your hands to blocks or the floor. This time, maybe walk your hands back a little bit. Take an inhale, lengthen out here, and then on your exhale, forward. Inhale, lift your chest. Exhale, hands to your waist. Inhale, rise to stand. And then step your feet together. And it will return to our mountain pose, arms down by your sides. You can take another balance pose here called tree pose. And we'll start by standing on the left foot. So bring the weight into your left foot. Lift your right heel. And then externally rotate your right leg. So you're turning the knee out to the side. You can position your foot anywhere along the inseam of your right leg. I'm sorry, anywhere along the inseam of your left leg. And then your hands, you can have your hands at your waist, right, palms together. You want to challenge your balance? You can reach your arms up overhead. And try to avoid, if you notice that you're kind of sinking into the upper hip, right? Try to avoid doing that. Try to kind of lift the hips and keep yourself centered over your standing line. And if you do fall out of the pose, you do have to put your foot down. It's okay, you just come right back. And notice how your body kind of moves around and wobbles a little bit in your tree pose. And that's good, that's your foot and your ankle and your calf muscles all just kind of working together to help keep you balanced and to help strengthen. So allow yourself to open the wall. Just a couple more breaths. And then we'll release the side. So place your right foot down. You can shake out your legs a little bit, shake out your arms. Sometimes it can feel good to kind of stretch along the top of your foot. I have to kind of tuck my toes under a bit, stretch to the top of the foot. Was good for me to try that. Maybe circle your ankle around a couple times. And then we'll set up for the other side. So again, coming back to your Tadasana. This time we'll stand on the right foot. So lift your left leg, left heel. Turn your knee to the side. And then place your foot somewhere along the inseam of your right leg. It can even be on your knee. I know sometimes you're told not to do that in a yoga class. It's actually perfectly safe as long as you don't have any pre-existing injuries in the knee area. So just put it wherever is comfortable for you. And then again, hands can be at your waist, at your heart center, or reaching up overhead. I'm gonna keep my hands here on my waist for balance purposes. It's helpful when you're in a balance pose like this to find a point on the ground that you can focus your gaze on. And in yoga, we call that the drishti point. So you can focus your gaze on your drishti. And maybe watch your inhales and your exhales. Think about your exhale moving towards that point on the floor, and your inhale being drawn from that point on the floor. So just a couple more breaths. Again, notice the wobbles. Notice the movement that your body is doing, even though you're trying to stay relatively still. Right? And it's okay to allow for this movement. It's even okay to fall out of the pose. You don't want to take our yoga practice so seriously that we don't allow ourselves sometimes to fall out. Go ahead and release your foot. Again, shake out your legs. Arms a little bit. Maybe take that under scratch, that top of the foot stretch. Okay, so the next pose that we're going to do is a squat. I know this is challenging for some people, so we'll give you some alternatives. One thing that I like to do with a squat lately is to use a block underneath my hips. So if you want to try that, you can position the block and then stand with your feet a little bit wider than your hips, a lot wider than your hips actually, with your toes turned out to the side. It's okay if your heels come off the ground and you're squat. If your feet begin to ache, you can roll up a blanket and put a blanket under the heels. So we're going to lower down from our standing position. And if you're using the block under your hips. You can just sit down on the block. This is a good option, especially if there's pain or difficulty in your hips or your knees. Okay? If it's not good at all for you to be in a position like this, you can do a similar pose on your back, where you can lie on your back and draw your knees in towards your chest and maybe flex your ankles. So for those of you who aren't doing the full version of the squat, maybe lie down and take the reclining version. And if you're decided not to use the block at all, then it would look something like this. And again, it's okay if the heels are off the floor. So hands and heart center, press your elbows together if you're in the upright position. Just kind of shift a little bit from side to side, you know, leaning into one foot and then the other. Okay, so our next pose that we're gonna do, for those of you who want a little bit of a challenge, is an arm balance called crow pose. And if you don't want that kind of challenge, you can stay right where you are in your squatting position or in your reclining squat position. If crow pose is a new pose for you when you're just learning to balance on your hands, it's a good idea to have a block or a blanket or a bolster or something that you can place in front of you so that if you do fall, your cushions, right? You'll fall on the bolster instead. So I'll show this from the side view. So we actually enter crow pose using a slightly different squat. Instead of having my feet apart, I'm gonna bring my feet together for this squat. The toes are together, and then the knees are gonna come wide, and the hands come to the ground, very much like you have them for your downward facing dog. Fingers are spread, and next fingers are pointing forward. You can draw the elbows in and down, and then take your knees, you're gonna hug your knees around your upper arms. Look in front of you, shift your weight forward into your hands, and see if you can lift one or maybe both feet off the ground. And you might wanna give this a couple of tries. Another way of coming into it that's helpful if you're learning it is to actually start on your block. So what that looks like is you would take your block, bring your feet up onto your block, and then do everything else the same. Okay, spread your fingers, elbows in, knees hug the upper arms, shift forward, and then again, maybe one foot, maybe both feet come off the block. So you can give that a couple of tries. And then when you're done, sit in a comfortable seated position. I'm gonna sit on my block here. And just kind of circle your wrists around a couple of times. Maybe and press your hands down. Get interlaced your fingers. People like to do this kind of swirling motion. I don't usually find this super helpful, but I know a lot of people like this. So moving your hands around and stretching out a little bit for the backs of your wrists. We're going to take a few seated stretches here. And I currently have a little bit of a back issue, and so even if I didn't, I would probably use the blanket. And I usually set up my blanket so that I'm seated on the blanket. And that way it lifts my hips a little bit and allows me to have kind of a more natural curve to my spine. So you can set that up or maybe sit up on your bolster. And then extend your left leg out in front of you. Your right foot can be hugged in towards your left thigh. Take an inhale, lift through your chest. And then on your exhale, walk your hands forward and fold over your front leg. And then see here, you can begin to slow your breathing down. You can take some long, slow inhales and exhales. Next inhale, we'll come back to the upright position. And then turn towards your bent knee for a little twist. Right hand can come behind you. Inhale, lift through your chest. And then exhale, deepen into your twist. Take your gaze up behind you. Turn back towards the front of the room. We'll switch sides. Send your right leg up. Bring your left foot into your thigh. And hands on either side of your right foot. You press into your right heel. You have a little bit of a bend into your right knee. Take an inhale. And then on your exhale, fold forward, walking your hands towards your right foot. You don't have to ever hold on to your right foot or grab for your right foot. You can keep your hands just where they are on the mat. And again, see if you can slow your breathing down here. On your next inhale, lift your chest. And then we're twisting this time towards the left leg. So bring your left hand behind you. Take an inhale, lift your chest. And then exhale, deepen into your foot. Your next inhale, face forward. And now take both feet wide, just as wide as is comfortable for you. You can again have a little bit of a bend in your knees. This is really putting a lot of strain on your inner thighs or on your hamstrings. You can always bring the soles of your feet together and take a different kind of a stretch. So I'm going to take the wide legged stretch for now. Inhale, lift, lengthen through your spine. And this is where you stay if you have back problems or it is uncomfortable for you to fold forward. You can stay right here in the upright position. Otherwise, you might walk your hands forward a little bit. Maybe drop your head. Come back to your breath. On your next inhale, lift back to your upright position. Use your hands to kind of assist your legs in coming back in. And then we're gonna lie down on our mats. Okay, so you can move your props off to the side, maybe keep them handy, especially your blocks. Lie down on your mat. Bend your knees so that the soles of your feet are on the ground. Arms alongside your body. And now begin to lift your hips on the in-breath and lower your hips back down on your in-breath. Inhale, hips lift. Exhale, lower. Inhale, lift. Exhale, lower. Just start to, or continue to follow that pattern. Just follow in your own pace for a few more breaths.
Now the next time you lift your hips, we're gonna keep the hips lifted. Now you can either keep your arms just where they are. This is actually the version that I prefer. You could interlace your hands and kind of shrug your shoulders beneath you, maybe allowing you to lift your hips a little bit higher. And if neither of those appeal to you, you can take your block, bring your block underneath your hips, and then rest your hips. You want the block to be crossed your hips so that your sacrum is fully supported and in a supported bridge pose. And we'll just spend another few breaths here in whatever version you're in. If you're in the supported version, move your block off to the side, lower your hips to the ground, drive your knees in, and just take little circles. Pull your knees around a few times. And then in the other direction. And then bring your knees over towards the right side. And dropping into a spinal twist. This is another place where you can use your bolster or your blanket placed underneath your legs. Extend your arms out and turn your head towards your left hand. If that's too much on your neck, you can keep your knees up towards the ceiling. And your inhale, bring your knees back to center. And then exhale, drop your legs to the left side. Bolster. Underneath. Again, you can turn your head towards the right or keep your knees up at the ceiling. Keep your head towards the ceiling. Close your eyes and let's go. Inhale, bring your knees back. We're going to sit up here for our final resting pose. I always like to have a bolster or a blanket under my knees because it makes my back feel a little bit better. But you can also lie flat if you like. So we're just going to do this for a couple of minutes. If you want to take a longer shavasana, you can turn off the video now and then lie down for as long as you want. As you settle in, let your arms rest by your sides with palms facing up. Close your eyes. Allow your eyes to fall deep into their sockets. And just let your breath move easily and naturally through your body. Begin to deepen your breathing. Find small movements in your fingers and in your toes. Pull your wrists and your ankles. Then draw your knees to your chest. And you can walk side to side a couple times. Then when you're ready, roll yourself over onto one side. Keeping your head heavy and your eyes closed, push into your hands and come to a seated position on your mat. Let's bring our hands to heart center. I want to thank you very much for joining me today for our yoga practice. Have a wonderful rest of your day. Namaste.